Hello guys, welcome to the first video of the post-processing series in which we want to talk about how to post-process the results of computational projects. So why we start with post-processing? As I have a personal answer to that, post-processing is one of the most important parts of a project in which you want to sell your results, in which you want to present what you've done. So I always say that it's important, but also for this series, for this channel, it has another purpose for us, that I want to show you the first projects about which I want to talk and also show you the details and how to build them. So I have compiled a set of results from some of the projects that I've done in the first 2 years of my PhD. These are really primary results, but I think they're enough to demonstrate the concepts of post-processing using ParaView. So yeah, let's go to the results first in the first video. That can be, as I said, it can be also an introduction to the projects. So here, the first one, the first set of results, I have some cell viability simulation results in which we wanna simulate some islets. It's related to tissue engineering. Just imagine that if we wanna put some islets inside these wells, which in these wells, it provides oxygen to the islets, and islets are indeed living entities. They need oxygen. And then we wanna simulate that to see if the provided oxygen is enough for the viability of the injected cells or not. So it will produce results like this. You see that we have an islet here inside this well that is similar to the geometry of the real wells. And we want to see if the provided oxygen is enough for the cells to stay alive. And then we want to, for example, plot a change of oxygen concentration over this line to see if it produced something like this. And that this can be a good first project, let's say, as an introduction to ParaView. And then we will also have some sort of automation in which we want to, for example, simulate two islets like this over time, and then change the distance between these two islets and then try to post-process the results in an automated way instead of doing them one by one. We want to plot the oxygen concentration over a line and to see what happens and produce something like this. So that's also good as a demonstration, I think. This is my main topic in the PhD, which is indeed degradation and corrosion inside a body. So this is a very primary results that I had in the first, I think, 3 or 4 months of my PhD. But yeah, that's pretty cool to see, different concepts of ParaView in this visualization and also in post-processing. So we want to simulate something that is degrading over time, and we want to see how we can create such videos. Then we will go for some fluid flow things and how to post-process velocity fields. And also important, that's very interesting for me to talk about, is how to render videos and animations inside ParaView using GPU. They will create something like this. It is pretty cool. And also, it's visually, it's more beautiful and better to, let's say when you want to present it somewhere. If you want to present, for example, a convection, a diffusion, something like that, you can use GPU capabilities inside ParaView. And then also we have some some interface tracking problems. These are indeed pretty cool video, pretty cool projects to talk about later when I covered most of the fundamental theories, required theories. But the topic here is we want to simulate growth of tissues inside scaffolds. In tissue engineering, they put cells on scaffolds and then they start to proliferate. So this is indeed a simulation of cell proliferation, but also the effect of the surrounding of the scaffold geometry and the growth. And this is indeed very nice to talk about this, but this is simulated in two methods, phase field and level set. We will talk about the details, but here we want to discuss about the post-processing. Like this one is how we can post-process when the data range is changed and is updated in each data step. And this is, for example, the output of the phase field. We want to see how to create this sort of course, that was very simple, but for example, yeah, this one that is indeed very similar to these real figures of their real experiments. So these are indeed the project. The last one I forgot to talk about. This is very interesting from the technical perspective, from scientific perspective. This is another way of solving equations, differential equations, using numerical techniques, but instead using artificial neural networks. And this is the implementation of the same method, same interface tracking technique, but in this kind of neural network solvers called physics-informed neural networks, or PINNs. And this is one of the results that I have for that, for the tissue growth. But I put it, when you see this is pretty simple and very, very similar to the previous one. But in fact, there are some differences in the way that it produces the output. So from the post-processing perspective, I think it is worth to discuss this. So I put it here, I think this is interesting. So we will start to post-process these files to create such the videos that I showed you from the raw data, from the raw simulation outputs. Make sure to download these files from the link that I put in the description below, and then we are ready to go. So stay tuned.